What's up guys, I got a number of requests to do a tutorial on the Mainstreet sets. Now since this is a very large collection of sets, I also want to make a very large video about it. And hopefully this will actually work. I'm kind of nervous because it's the first time that I'm actually doing something like this. But I've divided the video into four main sections, which you can navigate in the video description, but hopefully also in the video itself. And basically, the first part, I just kind of want to look at the pieces that the set has, how you can use them, and I'll basically focus on the main, most popular pieces of each of the 9 sets. In the second part, I kind of want to build a building. This is usually what most tutorials do, but in this tutorial, I kind of wanted to do some more things just to really show you what you can do with the set and kind of help you on your way to build your own things. But the second part will mainly just focus on how you build the buildings using these sets. The third part will look at what kind of other sets you can use in combination with this set to create buildings. And the last part will be about showing you some examples of buildings that I've built with it and just showing you how those things were made using these sets. So if there's any parts of the video that you're not too interested in, because for example you already kind of know what pieces there are in the sets, feel free to skip those parts of the video. But in any case, let's just go ahead and dive right into it. So here on the left you can see me opening the pack in the game, and there's actually many more pieces than you can see on the ground over here, which is mainly because I really only took the pieces that I most commonly use and that are most popular in the set, just to focus on the things that I think the sets are best to do, because the first set is actually also in a chronological order, the first set that came out, and you should actually be able to just build good Mainstreet buildings with just the first set, because it has everything you need. The other sets are really just expansions to it, but to be quite honest, there is actually some outdatedness to this set, so I usually don't use all of the pieces of this set. I want to start off with the walls, because these are the standard types of walls that you kind of want to use with your Mainstreet. The only downside to using the walls from the first set, which I think are still pretty good stucco walls, is that they don't really have a very high quality texture, as you can see, and there aren't any diagonals or bay windows, stuff like that. So there's really a bit of a lack of shapes that you can use in terms of the placement of the walls and stuff like that. There is a really good balcony though, and as far as I know, this is the only balcony like this for Mainstreet buildings, so you're always going to want to come back to the first set if you want to get those balconies in. Also, as you can see, there are some cornices which you place under the roofs, which are also included in the first set. The only downside to the first set with that is that these cornices, as you may be able to see, don't have a very large draw distance. If I zoom out like this, you can see them slowly disappearing, so I usually don't really like to use these cornices, but if you're just getting some close-up shots, you can easily use them. These are some base walls. You usually use these toward the ground of some kind of building, just to kind of support it with. And these arches is something that I placed in here because I see these things being used quite often in Mainstreet buildings, and it's always just a nice little touch you can add to buildings. If you don't really have any real arches on your walls, but you still have some pillars on the sides and you just want a little bit of decoration, you can always just put these things on the walls and it'll just look a tiny bit better, and I kind of like them. These are just the standard roofs, and this is really something for which the first set is still very usable. On the left side you can kind of see those roofs the way they just are. That's the way they pretty much come with the pack, and on the right side you can see some trims but also some roof end pieces, which you can see right here, I think. Yeah, there we go. We have some trim kind of things, which is basically you place these over the roofs like this, and that just makes it look a tiny bit better. And the same goes for these other pieces. The only thing is that for corners and straight pieces, you're going to have to add the cap just like that, and it doesn't come with the trim. Now, as soon as you get the placement right, this is always a bit tricky. That's how that works, basically. And then you can get a corner trim like that, and that's how you make the roofs. Then there's another dormer over here, which I think is a pretty usable piece. The only downside to using the dormers in the first pack, and this is why you won't see me using the dormers too often, is they have a very high poly count, and if you zoom out, they start disappearing quite quickly, as you can see. So that's a bit of a downside to that. Then we have these railings, which aren't supposed to be used as normal fences, but rather you place them on the roofs. So for example, this is the roof spire railing. This fits on the roof like that, and basically you can add a decoration to the roof spire like that. And the idea is you place these all around the sides of the roofs, and that just makes it look a tiny bit better. Now coming to the second set, one of the first things that you'll notice is these columns. These can be used just for decorations outside of the buildings as well as for the interiors, and they're really just quite nice things that you can use on the corners of buildings, stuff like that, just to decorate it. And the same goes for this kind of thing, although I must note that this Emporium Annex decor kind of thing is something that has a 1.5 tile placement, so it's not just one full tile, but the pieces in this Emporium thing are really just pieces that you have to use separately, and you can't really mix too well with other pieces, so that's something to keep in mind. Then we have some roofs, and these are really nice roofs. These are the only 1H roof in the entire set, and 1H roofs are quite rare in general, and I just really like these roofs. They work quite well for facades. We have the standard 1H roof like that. This is a 1H peak. Then we have the eaves, which you place on the sides of those roofs, and a railing, which you can place on the side of the end of the roof. And these are some cornice pieces that you can place on the sides of walls in a similar way to how these cornices are placed, except these ones are supposed to support this type of roof. Then we also have some more Emporium kind of things. As you'll notice, this is also on a 1.5 tile placement. So these things go actually quite well with these objects that have that same placement. But in general, they're quite nice to use because you really get that shop kind of look with them. The last thing to note about the second set is that it comes with a number of posts and trims. And these may not look like much, but usually when you have, for example, two walls that intersect and start glitching, or you just want to have some posts in general, you can just place these posts anywhere, and they're actually quite versatile. It's just that you kind of have to come up with a use for it, but usually whenever you need something like either a horizontal or a vertical beam, you can just use these things, and they work quite well for Main Street buildings. Now, the third set is a set that I usually just use for the walls, but there are actually some other quite usable pieces in this set. For example, we have these cornice caps, and these are supposed to be used at the front of facades. For example, you have a facade at the end of the building, and you can fit these pretty much perfectly on these cornices that you would have there. And that's basically how you can, for example, decorate the front of a building. And the same goes for that other cornice cap, and these are actually quite good pieces. There's also a pretty usable door. I think I see this quite often. At least I like to use this thing. And these posts are actually really nice. You can, for example, support porches with that. It's actually quite usable. But the walls, I think, is really the best thing that this set has to offer. It has three different types of walls, and they're actually quite nice. We have the standard type of brick wall, and some people may recognize that this is actually the same texture as Shyguy's Planters, which is a set that has the same type of wall, except it also has it in curves. And as you can see, that's pretty much exactly the same texture. So that actually does help the set make be a little bit more versatile. Then we also have a different kind of brick texture. This one is slightly more modern and really a little bit more polished, and I just like using this one as well. It's also a little bit more dark than this one, so you can kind of change the colors in that. Now here we have the last walls in the pack, and this actually has the same texture as the walls in the first set. So let me see if I can place one of those. So as you can see, it's pretty much the same thing, except it comes with other windows and doors and stuff like that. So that's actually quite usable if you're using the walls from the first set. And also this set comes with some pretty good windows. I think this is one of the best windows that you can use from all the 9 sets. And a nice little bay window which has its own little roof like that, which is also quite nice to use on the sides of buildings, especially on corners. The fourth set really just has some random odds and ends. Basically, these are some cornice caps as well. You can place these on the tops of buildings just for facades and things like that. What's notable about this is that this has cornice 2 and a low poly version. Now, if you remember that I was complaining about the first set having that cornice that, you know, didn't really work because as soon as you'd zoom out, it would disappear. Well, Shyguy actually put this cornice in here with slightly less poly, so if you zoom out, you can still use this cornice. So my tip is, if you're using the cornices from Shyguy's Mainstreet 1, use this main kind of thing from Shyguy's Mainstreet 1, but use these cornice details from the Shyguy's Mainstreet 4, and that means that if you zoom out, it's still visible, and that really helps. Moving on, there's a bunch of different objects. We've got a wider door, which is a slightly larger than the other door we've just seen. Some counters for if you're doing some interiors and you want to build a bar or a shop or something like that. These are some interior kind of pillars. You can use these in inside buildings just to support the structure. And here's also a small planter, which is actually quite nice for paths. And you'll notice that there are also some roofs in here, but it seems as if I took a different shade of red, but that's actually not true. This roof is actually a darker version of the roofs that you've seen in the first set. which is actually really nice. I actually prefer these roofs over the ones in the first set because they have that darker texture. The only thing that you do have to keep in mind is if you want to have those trims and caps, you're going to have to go back to the first set and put them on the roofs like that. Also, one little piece that this set has, which is also quite nice, is this little stepping stone kind of side for the roof, which always looks good if you want to place something on the side of the roof, if it doesn't end with a corner, like something like that. There's also a small dormer in it, which I really like. It kind of works in the same way as the dormers from the first set, except this one has a much better render distance, so this one won't disappear as quickly. As you can see, there are also some simple path covers, but they're really not that usable as they don't have any curves or anything like that. But still, if you want to use this for a sidewalk or the middle of your thing, it's actually quite usable. And it also has a planter in the middle, which is also quite nice. And here is a little cinema thing, just for people who want to build a cinema. We've got some curtains just to add to the windows of that thing, which you can get from the earlier sets. And a little thing that I don't even know what you call these things. It's pretty nice. Anyway, moving on. I always like to say that the fifth set is only good for two things: paths and balls. I'll explain that in a bit. First, we have another couple of cornice caps, which are also quite nice. So if you do want a bit of variation between your facades, what kind of caps you're using, then you can really just scroll through the sets and see whichever cap from whichever pack you kind of like there. Here are the path covers, which, as you can see, these ones do have many curves and even some curbs for the size of the path covers, and a pretty nice lamppost that I also kind of like to use on the main streets. The last two objects, and these may seem like nothing, but they're actually quite commonly used, are these golden balls. And this is the only set in the game, as far as I know, that has these golden balls. So if you want to have some type of golden ball on, for example, your church or the towers of your castle, then this is the set that you want to go for. Now, Mainstreet 6 is one of my favorites because it has many usable pieces. First off, we've got these little dormers with different placements, both diagonal and straight, which is also very handy. Then we've got a couple of new cornices, yeah. And these are actually just a tiny bit more fancy than the first ones, because as you can see, the first ones had that square thing in the middle, but this one has some kind of diamond-ish shape, which is, it's not a diamond. I don't even know what I'm talking about. In any case, moving on, these cornices are just pretty nice. We've got some wainscots, which you can use for both the interiors as well as exteriors of buildings, though I wouldn't be too certain about using it as exteriors, but still, these can even be used for alpine buildings, wherever you want to have some wooden influences. There's also some pretty nice windows, kind of like using those, and also some new walls. Now, these are the walls that I like using the most from all the Mainstreet sets, and you may see why, because it has a very nice texture, just a very light, subtle texture like that. If you color it, it still has that same texture, except it, you know, it has the color that you gave it. They don't have to be white always, and there's loads of half pieces and diagonals and even angled pieces that go up like that, so it's a really versatile set when it comes to that. There's also some new roofs, as you can see, some diagonal roofs, both in the dark texture from Shyguy's Mainstreet 4, as well as the light texture from Shyguy's Mainstreet 1, some pieces to just connect that to straight pieces, which is basically what you'd use this for, and of course some new roof caps, because you want to have those for the diagonal roofs as well. Then another thing that we have is a little bay kind of thing, which goes with these bay windows, which you can just simply place, add a roof to like this, and then you have a nice little bay thing. And there's also some amazing door action in this set. Basically, how this works is you can place this wall just to get those windows, then you can put these curtains behind it in any way that you like. Then you can even put this wood either behind it or in front of it to have that as a decoration. And this is basically the door and the door kind of post thing that you place in the middle. And that means that you have a door which consists of many, many pieces, but there's a lot of details on this one. So I really like to use this one. Now, Mainstreet 7 has a lot of interesting objects, but I think its best things are its restaurant objects and its round tower. It's also got a couple of base moldings, which you can use as these are basically the same bases as the ones that you see in the Mainstreet set 1, except it's a little bit of an expansion to it with diagonal pieces and things like that. There's also a couple of other random objects, but really, I think that these round towers that you can see over here are about the most popular object from this set. This little cap is supposed to be placed on them. There's both a light and a darker texture to it. And usually you can place these things on the sides of buildings, decorate it a tiny bit with these posts over here, and have some windows to it. And that's basically how you have these, how you build these things. Also, I should probably say that this straight window can actually be placed on just straight walls, and it's a really nice window to use, so I really like that one as well. Now, the last thing that we have in this set, and this is something that it's quite commonly used for, is some tables and chairs that you can use quite nicely for restaurants, so I really like that as well. The 8th set comes with a couple other placements for the cornices that we've seen before, which is also quite handy, and in a couple of new counters which you can use for the interiors. But one of the things that I really like about this set is the fences and balustrades that it comes with. As you can see, there's a little balustrade over here, and there's this post and this thing as well. And these are basically pieces that you can mix and create some fences with. For example, this post has to go with this thing like that, but it can also go with that, and it's just pretty handy. So I usually like to use these things either for paths. This is really nice for balustrades, for example, balconies, things like that. But you can even use it on roofs instead of the roof trims that you've seen in the first set. There's also some fences over here, which have a bit of a Victorian-ish influence. If you want to get some of that ironwork stuff in your park, you can use that as well. Now, as much as these things look like fences, they actually aren't. You can use them as fences in some way sometimes, but the main thing that they're used for is to support the roof structures or just kind of make them look a little bit more nice in a way. For example, you're using these posts to support a roof, then you can add these things to it and just make that look a tiny bit nicer. If you can get actually the right placement, that is. Let me change that because that doesn't look good. Okay, like this is more like how it should be done. Now, these things may look like path covers, but they're actually supposed to be used for roofs. If you still have some roofs and, you know, there's some gaps and you don't want to fill it up by just spamming roofs from the first set, for example, then you can neatly just place these things on the roofs and finish that. Now, these things may look like walls, but they're actually just interior decorating. If you want to get some of that wallpaper on the insides of your buildings, if you're having some interiors, then you can place these. Also, we have some very nice doors over here, both straight and diagonal. I really like these ones, where this is the wall that you place, these are the posts, and these are the doors themselves. Now, if you want to get some curtains, you can just go back to the old sets and get those things. And last but not least, there's a heap load of amazing windows in this. First of all, we've got a nice little dormer over here, which is slightly larger than the other dormer. So if you have a large roof, I really recommend using this thing instead of the smaller ones that we've looked at before. These are some pretty flat windows, but they have some nice shapes. And this is just the rest of the windows that we have in here, as well as a little bay thing that is, instead of being diagonal as the bay we've seen before, this one is straight and it also looks really good. Now, when it comes to adding details and decorations, the 9th set is really the way to go. This has pillars that are quite commonly used, actually. They might even be used more often than Ralphie's pillars. They're just really nice, and it's really great to use these, for example, for galleries that you're using underneath your buildings. But you can even build entrances with it. Basically, any type of classical influenced building that you want to build, I really recommend using these pillars. They also come with many different placements, and it's quite handy in that way. Then over here, we have some cornice pieces. Now, these may not look like it, but these are actually cornice pieces and they all go together. As you may notice, this piece is pretty much the same thing as this, except it doesn't have that entire structure around it. And this cornice piece goes on top of that piece. Wait, I'll see if I can show that off in a minute. This piece can work in a lot of ways, but I think it also goes quite well with this cornice, just to put on the top of your walls before you go to the roofs over here, for example. And you can even get a nice cornice cap on that. And yes, this is quite an overused cornice cap, but it's really a beautiful thing. Other things that you can use to support this structure include this cornice support, which is pretty much sometimes used to support this thing from underneath it, kind of like that. And the same goes for some other pieces. Instead of this thing, for example, you can put this cornice cap on it. And that's basically how these pieces work. Then I still have this thing left over here, but this is really just a kind of random thing that you can use for any type of decoration that you're really looking for, whether it would be above a door, for example, or underneath a roof. This kind of thing just kind of fits over pretty much anything that you really wanted to. Also, we have yet another door. This is the largest door from all of the Mainstreet sets, so if you really want to get a large door in your building somewhere, then I would recommend using this one. And these are actually 1.5 tile pieces that you can use with the Emporian things from the 2nd set. So that's something to remember about those things. And the last set also comes with some really nice windows. If you're using these smaller windows, by the way, you need to get these decorations around it. And we also have some slightly larger windows over here, and they each come with their own awnings. About those awnings, by the way, every single set that has windows also has awnings in it for the windows, and I really just recommend spamming those things on your windows to make them look better. Now, this set also has two types of windows. You can see a slightly smaller version of the window over here, and this is the larger version. Now, as you may notice, for the smaller version, you're going to have to add this extra decoration if you want to have it. separately, and there are also some awnings available for both windows, as you can see, and they are also recallable. And one thing to think about is the fact that every single set that has windows, and I think that's every set actually, also has some awnings. They're all in the first part of the set. So all the way at the top of all the sets, you can find all the awnings that you can use for them. And basically, that's what you can place on the windows if you really wanted to. Okay, so into the second part of the tutorial, I'll just try to build a building and show you all the things that, you know, you need to think about when you're building a Mainstreet building. One thing that I would like to say before you start building is get the game around 12 p.m, maybe 11 a.m. in game time, because that means that you won't have any awkward lighting. If you try to build, for example, at 9 a.m. in the morning, then you get a lot of light on one side of the building, but a lot of shadows on the other side, and that's generally not something that you want to have if you're trying to judge the look of a building. Another thing is to turn on the grid. It really helps when you're trying to build things to see whether something has a different placement or not, or to see whether some pieces can actually work together. Or for example, if you're placing walls inside out or outside out, and is that even a word? In any case, I'm going to show that in a bit right now. I always like to start with the walls because that means that you kind of get a grasp of what the building is going to look like. If you start, for example, with different details like a roof or something like that, it's really hard to judge what the shape of the building is going to be. And if you start adding all kinds of details, and then when you start adding the walls, it turns out that you don't really like the shape of the building, then that's just kind of a shame. So I always like to start off with the walls just so you kind of get an idea of that. I like to take 5H per floor. Now this may be very high, especially considering that these walls are 4H, but really this should do. And what I'm doing right here is I'm leaving some space for the possible borders between floors, as well as the base and the corners on top of this, because that's basically what you want to do. This is about the height that I like to have it. You can also have it like this, which means that it's 1H lower in total, and that also works fine, but I kind of want to have some kind of base division between these two floors. So I'm going to start building the walls like this, and then I'll just get a diagonal wall like this. This is really the set that I like to use whenever I get diagonals, because it's quite versatile and you really have enough pieces to do this. Now what you may notice about these walls is that I've placed them inside the grid, and this is what you want to do. If you're gonna have a building in these squares, then you want to keep the walls within these squares. The mistake that some people make is they start building the walls like this, which means that they're going to stick out, but then certain details, accents, and maybe even windows won't really protrude well from the walls. So I'd advise against doing something like this and really keep your walls inside. Also, one thing is that bases and cornices do go outside, so if you keep your walls inside the grid, inside the specific grid, and place your bases and cornices outside this grid, then those bases and cornices really start sticking out a lot more, and that really helps the look of the building in the long run. Okay, so onto the cornices now. This is really just simple, just placing cornices on top of the walls. I mean, this is quite just a simple task right here. It's nothing really to say too much about this. The only thing that I would say about this is just remember, like I said, the walls are white, so I want to have those accents with colors and vice versa. If these walls were, for example, brown, then I'd want to have these cornices be white, and that's basically how that works. Also, you can have some slight differences in accents like this. So for example, for cornices, I like to take a slightly different shade of brown for these details, so you can kind of see that they're sticking out. You can see them quite well. Now this still works if you're using similar shades, but if you're using, for example, a blue part of a cornice and then the other part of the cornice is going to be red, then that's really not going to work out. You're going to look for similar shades of similar colors, but not have too much contrast going in within these accents. Now the next thing I'd advise to build is to get the roofs done, and once again this is just to kind of see what the general shape of the building is going to be and whether you'll like it like that. So I'm going to start off with the roofs from the first set because I do want that lighter texture for this building. So I'm going to get that roof over here, if I can actually find it, that is, and place that thing like that. This is about the desired height that you'd want these things to be. And then from the sixth set, again, you can use this plug to just connect those roofs like that, and then it should all be good. Now we're going to finish these roofs by adding some plugs, and for that I'll use the plug from the sixth set just for that diagonal piece, and you can use the plug from the first set for any straight piece or a corner or something like that, and that should all work fine. Okay, let's see, here we go, the roof cap, that's what I meant. Okay, there we go, and I think that looks pretty good. So we've pretty much decided on what the basic shape of this building is going to be, and now it's time to start adding some details and accents and things like that. Now for the base, I always recommend using the base from the first set. However, as you can see, this one doesn't have any diagonals. So if you want to get some of those diagonals, and you're going to have to go to the 7th set and get the diagonal base from that. And that should fit pretty much perfectly. See, there we go. And that looks pretty good. And just as a decoration on these bases, you can place these base molding fancy pieces. And another thing that I really recommend doing is adding some small fancy corners like that, as well as their wall counterparts like that. And then it should be pretty much finished considering the base. Okay, now we need to connect these two parts, and you can pretty much use anything for this. I usually use something from another set, but since I'm just focusing on the Mainstreet sets right now, I'll just keep myself to the Mainstreet sets. But you can pretty much do anything over there as you like. The only thing that I'd advise against is using cornices, because then you really get something that sticks out, and they usually are meant to connect to the roof. So if you have cornices in the middle of the building, that's something I would usually try to avoid. But now, as you can see, we do kind of have some sharp edges over here which have nothing on them, and this is something that we generally want to avoid with Mainstreet buildings. So you can basically add some side bricks in any term, any kind of shape or size that you want. You can use, for example, these brick moldings to create some kind of corner for that. But since that looked a little too large for my liking, I think I'll just settle with these very small posts on the side and just kind of mark it off like that. On the bottom, however, I like to have some pilaster action, so I'll just add these pillars over here just to kind of support that, which looks a tiny bit more fancy than just those empty trims. Also, you've got to watch out with those trims and don't do what I just did right here, because as you can see, they have a placement which isn't exactly in the middle of a, tile like that. So you have to watch out with the placement and just kind of rotate them until they have the right placement, because as you can see, this one sticks out more from the building than this one. So basically, don't be me and actually place them right. Okay, let's see, is this the right placement? Yeah, there we go, that's good. Now this will be the basic building, some sort of shell, so to speak. Some sort of template on which you can then add the buildings and the doors and things like that, which is what I'll do right now. Now I'll go for a diagonal large doorway over here, and if you place these things, it is always good to place these curtains as well, because they really make this thing look a lot better, and it does look kind of empty when you don't place them. Now somewhere lower in the set should actually be the curtains that you have to place above that. Let's see, there we go, these things. And that looks pretty good. Okay, now I want to have some windows over here, and I decided that I want to have some windows from the 8th set. And since I do have those light brown accents, and I also have a red roof, I can also have that red color come back in these windows. Now the way that these placements work, you just have the standard placement, which is right on the lines like that. Then you have the offset 1 placement, which is just in the middle of that. And the offset 2 and 3 placement, which might both seem a little bit weird. But if you combine these two, if you place, for example, a 3 next to a 2 like that, you get a nice little double window. So that's a nice thing to remember. I always like placing these things. Now I'm still thinking this looks a bit empty and a bit boring, so you can always add the second, second decoration from the first set, just to kind of add a bit of arch action to that. It's always a nice little thing. Okay, and just for a bit of variation, I'll add the windows from the 7th set on the second floor, just to see how that kind of works. And I think that works quite nicely. Honestly, this is just a bit of experimentation. Always need to kind of find out what kind of windows do work on your building. Now, one thing that you'll notice about this is that there is still 1H left when it comes to actually getting to the roof. And this is that 1H that you do get extra when you add that bit of a extra layer between the two parts of the buildings, because this building in total is a 4H plus another 4H with 3H, 1H for the base, 1H for this base, and 1H for the corners, making it a total of a 11H building. And usually it's about 10H, but honestly an 11H really works as well, and a 9H is something you can do in a Mainstreet as well. It's just to add a bit of variation in the heights. There's usually not too much variation in heights when it comes to buildings on Mainstreet, but some buildings just have higher ceilings than others, and that's something to consider. Now you don't want to leave too many empty spaces on your building, so just for that extra bit of detail and just to get rid of that enormous white space that I had over there, I'm going to add a couple of these and then work that away with some new posts. Now this, by the way, is how you can use those columns to your advantage on the sides of buildings. Just by placing that like that, you just have a tiny bit of detail on the sides without actually breaking your walls in a way. Now, since I did put that many details on this thing, I don't think these very narrow posts will work anymore as corners, so I'll just replace them with some slightly larger cornerstones, and I think that works just better, because otherwise they'll get lost between all the details that I have on this building now. Now for the roofs, these are usually done by just adding some fences and dormers. So I'll start with the dormers first. These are the dormers from the 4th set. I kind of like these because they are not that big and not that huge. The 6th set also has a dormer, but that one is slightly smaller than this one. And the 8th set also has a different dormer, but that one is quite large. So I find this a nice in-between kind of dormer. Now you could be fine just adding the fences and leaving the roof like this, but I feel like I just want to have a small tower over here, especially because this building is kind of the main focus-ish kind of building, since it is located on a corner like this. So I kind of just want to try to get a tower in here. There we go. That's a start. And time for a good trim. Now the last thing we want to do with the roofs is to just add some roof trims. And that's definitely going to make that look a tiny bit better. And probably some fences as well. Yeah, there's definitely some room for some roof railings. Though I don't think you necessarily need it on a spire like this. You can always just try to get that on the sides. Yeah, these things are great. Now, all I really need is a cornice on top of that spire, maybe some small details on it, and then we're pretty much done here. Now, one other thing that people always like to mess with, and so do I actually, is just to add these small decorations like that, and especially on a spire like that, it's always cool to have a small decoration on top of it. Just kind of like that. Pretty nice. And there we have it. This is a basic Main Street building. Now, this is by no means the best Main Street building ever, nor is it a reincarnation of everything that has ever existed in Main Streets, but it is the basic build-up. You basically start off with a ground layer with some base walls, then build up to a second layer. Sometimes buildings already have a roof and they don't really have a second floor like this, but most of them do have three floors. And then you have the cornice, always the cornice underneath the roof, and then you get the roof where you maybe have a small tower, but you can also use those cornice caps from the things that I've shown before. So really, this is what it comes down to, and you can even try to experiment with many different colors. This is definitely not the only color scheme that you can use. For example, something like this is also something you can try. In this building, the accents and all the side details are white, while the walls have a different color. And this is by no means the best color scheme. This is honestly just something I randomly whipped up. But it's using that same kind of idea of having either the accents white or the walls white and the rest colored. And as you can see, even though I just randomly threw a bunch of colors together that don't even work that well, it doesn't end up looking terrible because you do have those white accents, and it, you know, it's still exactly the same building in terms of shape and what objects it uses, but it manages to get an entirely different look. Now, like I said, the last two things that I want to discuss in this video are just some small things, but just some ideas to help you on your way. And the first thing is, what kind of sets can we mix this with? And the answer to that question is actually pretty much everything. The Main Street sets is just something that you can mix with so many different things, and it really doesn't matter. You really shouldn't keep yourself to one certain theme and only use the pieces from that exact theme, because there are so many sets from all kinds of different themes that go surprisingly well with this set. For example, just recently I found out that actually the arches from Station Gym's Western things, for example, go really well with trying to get either diagonal or straight arches on a building that you really want to have. Like, these arches actually go quite well if you place them like that. Like, they even work a lot better if you actually place them a bit higher than that, because just with these windows, them being this low. But honestly, if you remove these things, it should probably work even better, honestly. Let's look at that. I accidentally just removed one of those columns, but that shouldn't really matter too much. I kind of need to move them out like that. Yeah, that's a bit better. Okay, let's see. And some diagonals over here. And as you can see, that makes an entirely different second floor, but I still think this looks really good. Maybe even better than the way it used to be. And honestly, you can even use these things over here. And that's basically how you kind of work with that. Just look into different custom scenery sets and see what works. Something that always works, and this is really something that just goes for every single Main Street, is get some random arches from whichever set it may be. You can get arches from Ralphie's Antique World. Actually, I'll show that off in a second. So we have the arch from Ralphie's Antique World right here, and if you place that over here, you actually do get a bit of cool arch action. Actually covers those wooden blanks over there, which wasn't entirely my intention, but you know, it still works pretty well. Let me remove that, look into another arch. There is also Coconutter's European Main Street, which is a set that recently came out. Well, relatively recently when it comes to custom scenery, which also has some arches in it. It's very nice, and we actually do have some diagonal arch action in here as well, so you can definitely use those for your diagonal buildings as well, even though I still have this thing over here. Let me kind of fix that. There we go. And see that? That is also quite a nice detail, and I should be able to get that on the straight pieces as well. Let's scroll down. Ah, there we go. That wall arch. And as you can see, it kind of glitches there. Let me remove that. There we go. That should be a lot better. And even that arch goes very well with this. So there's just many things you can try. And it's really hard to give a definite list of sets that you can mix with the Mainstreet sets. But pretty much everything goes. Coconut's European Mainstreet set is really a set that goes really well with it. Like, exceptionally well. Another set that goes quite well with it, although you do have to get some of the more castle influences if you really want to try this, is to try EZ's Walt Disney World Castle. Because using this, you can add all kinds of small castle details to your Mainstreet buildings, just to get a bit of that castle touch in there. Perhaps you kind of like to get some towers in there. Let me recolor that roof so it kind of fits the roof that I have right now. And then you do have a bit of that medieval influence in there. It's kind of cool. And you even have some of the larger towers that you might be able to place on the sides of your buildings, even though that does add a lot of fantasy influence. Let me see, that should be this tower, which should work quite well actually with this type of building, on which you can, I think, put this tower. Yeah, there we go, that's it. And even something like that could work with Mainstreet buildings. Honestly, there are many options when it comes to this set. Also, another set that goes well with the Mainstreet sets is this set, the Mainstreet Emporium, which this set, the Mainstreet Emporium, which is also by EZ, and it's made as a sort of expansion set to the Mainstreet sets. It's got some interesting pieces over there, which you could definitely use in your Mainstreet buildings as well. And as you can see, also some interesting roofs, and definitely a set you might want to try if you do have the Mainstreet sets and you want to try some new things. Another shout out goes to Ralphie's Arabian Days and Ralphie's Arabian Nights sets, which are sets that are known to be used for every single thing and every single theme in the game. And the Mainstreet is actually no exception to that. You can actually use these sets for many different things. For example, if you think that these posts don't really work too well, you might as well try one of the posts in this set. Honestly, it doesn't even it's not even that bad. And one other thing that is worth mentioning about these sets is that they have arches. Now, these aren't really too great, but this set definitely does have some nice arches. For example, you can replace this arch with one of these arches that does have more detail on it. Just something you can try. So there's loads of things you can mess with, and the options are pretty much limitless. Oh, not to mention that there's a pretty cool fountain over here. I need to not forget that. Never really realized that. Oh, you could even combine these two. Yeah. And also, one thing to remember, any Shyguy set works with any other Shyguy set. They are all very compatible with each other. For example, for the walls, you can also use the walls from Alpine Village, for example. If you make them white or whatever color you really want to have, it really fits for Mainstreet buildings as well. And if you do want to have some of those wooden posts and stuff, which the Mainstreet buildings themselves don't have in their packs, but some Mainstreet buildings do have some wooden influences, or maybe even some mock Tudor, then you can use the Alpine buildings for that as well. Now, the last set I want to talk about is Pets Efteling set, and oh my, is this set, and this set is a chaos. I'm very sorry. This set is not really fun to try to browse through, especially if you're not Dutch, but even if you're Dutch, it's really hard to see whenever anything is. But these little things, these peak things, are just so perfect to place on towers, and this goes really well with the Mainstreet things as well. For example, we have this little peak over here, but it's just kind of too small. You feel like you don't really see it too well. You can just place one of these on it and combine the three to kind of place a thing on it like that. Oh, wait, if I can get the placement to be right. And something like that. And you can use that on towers as well. For example, if you think that these towers don't really have enough of the peak stuff going on, you can place one of these on them. And it's just a tiny little detail. And these things also kind of work in the same way that these other things on the site work. So you can place these on top of these existing peaks and just add some of these things. This is most of the times when I open this set, it's actually just to get these three very small things, but they can add some really awesome details to your buildings. Now, last but not least, some examples from in the game. Now, you may recognize this park from my Let's Play. This is my Let's Play Mainstreet, and it is a very small Mainstreet, and it is built in a slightly different style than the standard American Mainstreets. But there is a lot to see about how you use the Mainstreet sets in general, and about recognizing pieces in the sets. One of the things that you see, for example, is that most of these buildings have about the same height. And as you can also see, there is a slight variation. Like, this building, for example, looks like a 9H in total, while this building looks like an 11. 7H and this one like a 12H, something like that. So there is a slight difference in height, and this is something that you do want to go for in a Mainstreet in general. There should be slight differences in height, but buildings should be around the same height. Always go for about 2 or 3 floors. 2 floors is really about the minimum that you want to have for a Mainstreet building, and you might get 4 floors in, but then again, this also really depends on the rest of your Mainstreet. If you have an entire Mainstreet filled with 5 floor buildings, something in a Chicago kind of manner, then just go for that, as long as it has about the same height, but also still a bit of variation to keep it interesting, is basically the way to go. Now, something you'll notice about this Mainstreet in general is that it has a street in the middle with sidewalks on the sides, and this is basically how many Mainstreets work. You enter through the entrance or underneath a train station, something around along the lines of that, and then you enter a small square, usually, where you have sidewalks is where the main buildings stand, and then in the middle you have some kind of street where there'll be a trolley or some random planters, and basically a space where most of the people can be able to walk. Something to remember is that a main street is going to be your entrance area of the park, so it can be very crowded at times, so make sure to not make a main street too narrow. Make sure that it kind of allows for a big stream of guests. Also, you might be able to see that this is actually the building that we made in this tutorial is kind of modeled after. One thing that you could note about this though is that this one kind of has a gallery underneath it, and this is just a bit of a personal thing. I always like to have these galleries on Main Street. They are quite a common thing, but really not that much. You have them here and there, but many buildings are just flat like that. Some even have some larger balconies. That's also something that you can mess with, a balcony like this. But really, when it comes to main streets, it's really hard to say anything that you should really do, because just follow a general style that you want to have and make sure that you get the right heights, get some kind of street in the middle with sidewalks and with sidewalks on the sides, and other than that, just let your creativity do whatever. And most importantly, have fun. That is really the most important thing. So that concludes my tutorial on the Mainstreet sets. I know this has been a very, very long video, and it might actually be way too long for anybody to really pay attention to and learn things about the sets, but I just wanted to really get a somewhat detailed overview and tutorial of the sets down, and hopefully you've been able to learn something from it. And if you have some feedback, if you have some ideas or anything that you think I could do better, please just do so, because I'm definitely not perfect and definitely not that experienced when it comes to main streets. So if there's something that you think I can improve upon, then just say so. And if you have a question about main streets or about custom scenery sets, or if I forgot something, just leave a comment about that as well. But thank you for watching in any case, and I'll see you guys later. Also, there might actually be some curtains in this set as well, though I really don't know for sure. No, there's no curtains. Okay. I'm going to cut that out. What the fuck? This is going to be the longest video I've ever made. Okay.